Legendary Hollywood heartthrob Tony Curtis has died of a heart attack at his Las Vegas home. The Oscar-nominated actor, famous for movies like Some Like It Hot, alongside Marilyn Monroe and Houdini, enjoyed a career that spanned 60 years. He was 85.
Tony Curtis knew early on he had charisma.
I knew there was something, I won't say special about me, but something different that cut me out from all the other guys.
He was born Bernard Schwartz in the Bronx, the son of poor Jewish immigrants. His father was a tailor from Hungary, his mother from Czechoslovakia. He joined the Navy when he was 17. When he got out, the GI Bill paid for acting school. An agent saw him, and Curtis was on his way to Hollywood. He moved quickly from bit parts to leads in swashbucklers like Alibaba.
We can't break through. We'll make our stand in the Great Hall.
He had all that dark hair and blue eyes, a nice figure jumping around, kissing girls, a lot of energy, hip-hop and jump around. I mean, how could you not go for me? I even went for me.
Ultimately, Curtis appeared in over 100 films, playing roles as diverse as escape artist Harry Houdini, a noble slave in Spartacus, a hustling naval officer in Operation Petticoat. In 1958, Curtis teamed up with Sidney Poitier in The Defiant Ones, in which they played a pair of escaped convicts. They both received Best Actor Academy Award nominations. But nothing was a bigger hit for Curtis than the classic comedy Some Like It Hot. Curtis and Jack Lemmon played two musicians running from the mob who join up with an all-girl orchestra featuring Marilyn Monroe. He was married six times, first to actress Janet Lee, the mother of Jamie Lee Curtis, the only one of his six children to enter show business. Curtis loved to paint, and he credited his art with helping him through a period of addiction to alcohol and cocaine in the 70s. But as much as he loved standing in front of an easel, nothing gave Tony Curtis more pleasure than standing in front of an audience. Manuel Gallegos, 10 News.